It's a pleasure for me to host this webcast today together with Heynen. And I would like to speak today about the Allegro Network Multimeter. I will do two parts. Number one, a very few slides, which are about what is the Allegro, that you understand a little bit the background. And then, of course, a live demonstration where you can see the ability, what you can do with the Allegro. So let me start with my first slide. Basically, my first slide is how can you do troubleshooting in 5 minutes? That was in the past, and that is our main approach and goal. The problem from my perspective today in networks is that it's the first method today where you transfer everything over one single cable. So before there was a telephone line, there was a TV line or a satellite connection only for TV, there was a power line. Today you can even transmit power and voice and video and everything over a single cable. And power might be something else, but the rest is mixed. And by having so much different data on one cable, it makes it very hard to debug for a few reasons. One is a lot of data, and the other is you need a lot of differentiated service or differentiated quality for specific services. VoIP requires very low latency, low jitter. Data transfer just requires, well, big buffers at the end, and of course a big pipe. So our approach is wherever you are in a network, you should be able to look in a very short time frame into any kind of packets and see what is going on here, what could be the problem. So we defined the Allegro as a box that must be a portable unit that is very easy to carry and should be very simple and easy to use, but should also combine, of course, high performance. So the portables go up to 40 gig and should allow you to see the network on all network layers. So it's not a device designed for exactly one use case. So it's not a VoIP debugger, for example. Of course, it can do VoIP, but it's designed to debug on many layers. We also thought about how can we install the Allegro in the best way. And we figured out that there are many ways how you can debug networks. Well, the easiest one is inline, which we always recommend if you have an access point, if you have one client PC, one SIP phone, where you would like to debug what's going on this very, let's say, low-end link, where the downtime of the link is not an issue for you. If it's in a productive network, we always recommend, please use a different method. For example, a tap, which is very good. It copies the packets and you have no influence into the network. Many customers start with a mirror port because it's easy to configure. You don't have to interrupt any cable, or with ERSpan, which is quite new, the support. We also accept PCAP analytics for historic, historic PCAP capture. So you did a capture a few months ago, you would like to reanalyze that. Well, here we can also see the question, what's the difference to Wireshark? Well, I totally like Wireshark. You will see in 10 minutes also the integrated Wireshark, what we have. The big difference is we can analyze big links in real time, and we can do that for terabytes and petabytes of data. And Wireshark is more a tool for the needle. So we are a very good pre-filter for Wireshark. Now the most technical slide, which is very important because we figured out what is the issue, why is it so complicated having a portable unit and displaying a lot of data. And we figured out that it's a database. So we decided, okay, we need two absolutely complete separate databases. Number one is in memory. So all statistics, all graphs, all correlated informations you see are only in memory. The reason is in memory is extremely fast in access, and we can display data there very, very fast. The second database is a packet ring buffer, which can be on SSD, on HDD, any kind of storage where we can store all packets or a part of them that we can extract packets again back in time. I'll show you in a minute. Very short, which appliances are available. So we have the 200, which is extremely small, designed low end. We always say, well, use it up to 50 PCs or servers in a network, which has to do with the database. It's just by the size limited to 2 GB and has 2 1-gig ports. A little bit bigger in the new solution is the Allegro 500, has more interfaces and has already integrated a high-speed SSD that you can record up to 4 GB in the ring buffer. So it's designed for multiple gigabit input. The larger units then go up to 40 gig for the 3000 and 10 gig for the 1000 and offer very, very, very big database memory. So we can go even up to 512 gigabytes of memory now with the newest DRAM modules, which we just got for testing. And here you have a lot more connection options. 10 gig, 40 gig, even 100 gig ports are available if you need the physical connectivity. And that allows you to debug larger networks. We have client networks with up to 50,000 servers behind, running over one Allegro. If this is not enough, which we have seen in the telco market, which is there very interesting, there's also a solution for sustained 40 gig capture and analytics and up to 100 gig analytics rate available, which is, for example, a good use case for ISP VoIP troubleshooting, where we troubleshoot, well, at the end, complete ISP in one solution. But also for we have universities who have already purchased that solution, where they can just look back in time whenever there was an issue in their network and they need just a long storage.